Those of you who keep up with what's going on in the world of music probably already know about World Beat, but for those of you who don't, it is the sound that promises to be the hottest one around in the 90s. World Beat is sort of a mixture of all of the rhythms from all the different cultures, Latin, African, all of them thrown together into one big sound. Some of the artists who are best known for it already are the Bay Area's own Carlos Santana and the South African group Ladysmith Black Mambazo. We caught up with Ladysmith when they visited the Bay Area not too long ago.
This is really the beat of the world, the music that came from the Congo, from the birth of mankind, and this is the world beat.
It's a very primitive vibration, and concerning everybody. Yes, it's a thing coming from the flesh, from the body, from the
soul.
Yeah, the soul.
Third music is the real, real heartbeat of the real people out in the streets. You know, and you can't block it. Not only is the beat coming from the heart, but the message is from the heart. And it's very simple and usually dignified. Lyrics that speak to all ages, all cultures. World music is dignified pop. It's pop that's non-ageist, non-sexist, non-racist. And it's people speaking because they have a message they want to get across. It's not so much, how can I write a song to get commercial radio play? It's what is important to me, what's important to my family, what's important to my son, what's important to the people around me in society, and that's what comes out so great in world music. And music reminds us that the Constitution is very alive, and it guarantees rights to every human being, woman and man, regardless of anything. Religion or anything, you know. I think the third world music or world music, more than anything, it speaks loudly about consciousness, uplifting consciousness, transforming and elevating consciousness. Because, you know, you can just make somebody smarter, but you'll still be a smart crook. So that's not saying anything. But when music makes you, like Bob Marley, and let me quote Bob Marley, again, one of the kings of world music. He said, open your eyes and look within. Are you satisfied with the life you're living?
Open your eyes and look within. Are you satisfied with the life you're living? We know where we're going. We know where we're from. We're leaving Babylon, we're going to the promised land.
So certain music gives you an incredible beat. You can be intoxicated with this beat. But when they put the lyrics on you, are you satisfied with the life you're living? Are you satisfied with who you are and the orders that you're taken from? You know, is this person enlightened by God? Why am I following him if he isn't?
The music is the roots of the people. The melody has what I call express the sentiment of the people. Now, I believe that the tradition is what keeps the nation strong. Now my music encourages my people to come together. Don't lose their hope to come together and do something, love each other. This music is for the people, all the nations, not nation, all the nation, black and white.
Hey, hey.
San Francisco, there's always been a wide international community. The Kennel Club on Sunday nights is one of the few places we can not only hear all different kinds of world music, but see it. I've worked real hard on getting professional quality videos from as many sources as I can. And I think at the Kennel Club, people can come for a couple, 3 hours, and hopefully touch base with every continent on the globe, hear several different styles of music.
You have to question authority, man. That's what music, third world music, reminds me every time I hear it. You must question authority, because rebellion to tyrants is obedience to God. Thomas Jefferson. He probably grew with Bob Marley too if he was still here, you know.
Yeah. So get up, stand up for your right.
Well, that is it for our first Bay Sunday show of 1991. Thanks so much for joining us today.
And tired of your hissing, skissing, trying to go to heaven in a hissing, skissing. We know and we understand Almighty God is a living man. You can fool some people sometimes, but you can't fool all the people all the time. And now you see the light. Stand up for your right.